here. So let me just get right into it. Now, K. Michelle has been in the media a lot lately, and it hasn't been for her music. Shall we say that?
Oh.
It's been for a lot of beef, a lot of, basically a lot of he said, she said, because you know K. Michelle, she's just dead on. She's just gonna say what she wants to say, and that's just it. So basically, you know, she's had her issues with Toni Braxton's sister. What's her name? Tamar.
Uh-huh.
Her and Tamar got into it. Her and Tiara Marie actually got into it. And now her and Paris, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Paris. She's from Love & Hip Hop. Atlanta,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah, no, exactly.
I just want to know, like, why, K. Michelle?
Like,
exactly. My thing is it a jealousy thing? Is it a, I don't know what it is, because it can't be for music, because undeniably her music is dope.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, she's a dope singer. You know what I mean? Whether she's singing something hard or singing something soft or,
word.
You know, so I want to know why K. Michelle, can we just stop? Like, please. To bring up this Bill Cosby thing again, this is gonna be a mess for a long time, because they just keep messing and picking. Like, leave that man alone. Like I said yesterday, it's impossible for you to tell me that a young lady was drugged, or these particular young ladies were drugged, and they remember everything.
Nah.
Like, you remember every detail.
Not back then.
But you were drugged. Come on.
BS.
And then this was 10 years ago? You didn't remember back then. But you remember 10 years later. What kind of drug was that?
Word.
Ma'am. Because I need to go back and get some memories too. So, can I get whatever that was? Like, seriously, I feel like this whole situation has just been blown over completely. You know what I mean? Like, it's too many people out here looking for the wrong things.
Word.
You understand me? Like, people are looking for a come up, because that's exactly what it is.
Word.
A come up.
So
they want some money, or they want some recognition for something.
Rape is a hustle.
I don't. It is. You absolutely right, because I promise you, it don't even have to be true. I can scream it right now. And I bet you, whoever I point out in this room, they don't take you. They don't even know if it's true. None of y'all ain't never even touched me ever in your life. You know what I mean? But that's just how it works, because it's a female's word against, you know, a man. And I was told that by an actual officer one time. You know what I mean? Like, and the dude didn't even touch the female. Like, we were all standing up there. He didn't touch her at all. But since she said it, and we were all standing there and said he did not touch her, they still took him.
Yeah,
it made it bad for the women that really go through.
You know? Right. Exactly. I don't understand the world. The world is a big mess. So we're going to give the world the mess of the week, too. It's all across the world. There's just a lot of bull going on. Like, you know what I mean? It's just unnecessary bull. These drugs are getting out of control. I see people, like, literally almost like comatose on the sidewalks, or like looking like a fish out of water type of thing, you know what I mean, where they gibbering. And I've never, what kind of drugs are those?
I
can't get dose. So we are gonna let him introduce himself.
What's going on, man? Represent Rosa on Jersey. Hey. 5,000.
Jersey in the building. This is what I love. I love it. You know what I mean? Just Jersey, supporting Jersey, just coming out, doing your thing. I love it.
Jersey
love it.
Love, yeah.
Absolutely. That's where it starts. So it's like your home, but you know Jersey is the home too. So you know, not sure. Definitely. So, what brings you here today? What you dropping off for? Some records? Some.
I got a new project with everyone. iTunes, Spotify. It's called Pain Cut Deep.
Pain Cut Deep.
Yeah,
PCD. Pain Cut Deep. Now let's get into that. Let's elaborate.
Yeah.
Let's elaborate on that.
Yeah.
Obviously, you were going through a particular time when that name, you know, popped up for a project.
Yeah.
So, you know, what's the significance behind that name?
It's more of my life story. This is like project number 5 now.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a continuum of my life story. I just really got more in depth of things that I revealed.
Mm-hmm.
That I never revealed before, and I feel like, you know, I always like to be honest in my music. I always like to speak on content, have good content.
Right.
It's more of that. So I think when I was going, the music started feeling like I got fun records on there too, but when I did that record, I was really going for my voice.
Right.
My relationship.
Keeps PG.
You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? So where the pain comes from, that's where the title came from.
Right. So I definitely can appreciate that. We have a lot of artists that come up here and they're actually into, I call it true rap.
Yeah,
you understand me?
Yeah,
you know what I mean? So it's just like you have a lot of these rappers who rap about things that aren't true. You know, like you could just look at them and tell, like, my boy, you ain't never did that. You ain't never served nobody. You was never on the corner. The cops never chased you. Like, you know what I mean? It's just certain people, like, not to say that you can read everybody like that, but it's just certain individuals, you know, you just know their music is not real. You understand me? So it's like when you have artists that come in and you can actually see it, and then you hear the music and it's like a lie, right?
Word.
Like, you know, and you get an appreciation for it. So I can definitely appreciate that. I don't like pretenders. I don't like frauds. You know what I mean? I don't like that. So I'm definitely interested in hearing what you brought today, because we had somebody yesterday that brought some heat. So we're just trying to keep the heat going. It's the party, baby. So you know, we got to keep it going. You understand me? You definitely got to keep it rolling. So I'm going to get into my first question. Okay? So, Roselle, New Jersey. Now, were you born in Roselle?
Oh, yes,
I did. That's it. You usually hear people, they say, nah, I was born here and I moved to Roselle. You know what I mean? But born and raised in that's what's up. So how is it over there? I don't really frequent Roselle. I mean, I've probably been over there like, four times.
It's like everywhere else, you know, it has its issues, you
right.
know, it has its problems, but then,
right.
for the most part, you got like hard working families mm-hmm. out there just trying to make it.
Right. Okay, so it's the usual. I mean, I shouldn't think it's no different because, I mean, it's still Jersey.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, whatever. But I love Jersey. Don't take that.
Oh, so you used to go to Club Pouya's over there?
Pouya's.
First of all, that sounds fancy.
Pouya's.
That's a spot.
He's shaking his head. No, it's not fancy at all. He's like, nah, sis. Nah, sis. It was the joint?
Yeah, it was jumping.
Oh, it was one of them. Oh, we got a bunch of them. We got to put like, nah, that ain't really it, but we want to have some fun.
It was
lit.
It was lit. Yeah, it was lit.
My team used to stay bleeding that spot, so I'm
going
to bump into you.
Oh, wow. You know Doughboy.
Oh yeah, that's my guy.
He's supposed to be coming through. Yeah, he's supposed to tell you what up, yo.
Midnight just be connected with everybody. Yeah, but they be like, yeah, Midnight, yeah, that's my boy right there.
Yo,
like,
shout out to Dog, man.
Yeah, I'm getting a little jealous of you. But whatever. Alright, so, born and raised in Roselle. Now, what kind of music are you particularly into? Because even, I know a lot of artists that even though they do a specific type of music, the music that they like to listen to can be completely different.
I'm everywhere with it. Like, I like club music. I like mm-hmm. Some of my favorite artists that I was inspired by coming up was Jay-Z,
mm-hmm.
50 Cent,
mm-hmm.
Nas, Pop.
Mm-hmm.
So I listen to even the new stuff like the day Kendrick, J. Cole.
Kendrick is too.
Oh, facts.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's doing
Weezy. I like Wayne. I grew up on Wayne.
You just brought up my boy. You just made me hogging.
Yeah.
That is my boy. You understand? That album. Yeah, you ain't good. Get it. You didn't listen to it.
Yeah.
Tell him
right
now. Yes, I love Wayne.
Hot
Boy. Yes.
Since he first came out.
For real, since his flow was just like sick from day one.
Day one.
Mm-hmm. He had you paying attention, and I've been tuned in ever since. That's just it.
Little brains, though.
I remember he had the afro on him.
Yeah, he had the afro.
Get it.
Wasn't that bling bling?
Before that, it was something before that too.
Right. When he got braids in that video, right? I think that's when he started the braids and bling bling.
Yeah, PT Cool.
Right.
Yeah.
Word.
Prowess.
Sick. All right. So, being that those are some of your the artists, you know what I mean, that you say that like inspired you, would you say some of your music reflects some of their music, or would you say you just have a whole different tune altogether?
I take it from there, but I think a lot of my music is original. Like, mm-hmm. I got a song on a project called Stay Strong, and mm-hmm. that was featured by Bruno, man.
Mm-hmm.
It was about police brutality, mm-hmm. things that the black community goes through, like a lot of the black
we
people.
We need one of them. We need more of those songs.
So, we did a video. I'm kind of upset because, like, a lot of the people that I know that have like the blog sites and the Instagram. Mm-hmm. They like they don't really post that type of stuff. They want to post the ignorance. And so like some of the ignorant records, mm-hmm. they'll take kind of that. But when it's talking about something that affects all of us, right. it seems like they don't want to show love to that.
No.
But the happy side about that is we have people like reach out and email us saying that they had outreach programs that help black youth, and mm-hmm. some of the people that was ahead of those programs were inspired by the video they were showing to some of the young kids and everything, and they was inspired by it. So I feel like I won with that, you know. So.
That's it. Yeah. That's it. If you can't, I'm gonna let you know something, and that's dope you said that. If you can't inspire people with what you do and what you're doing, kinda doesn't satisfy the need to do it. You know what I mean? It's like you're just doing it just to do it at that point. So it's dope that you've gotten that out of what you're doing, because I know a lot of artists that aren't even doing anything. It's like you're just an artist. I don't see you doing anything in the community. I don't see you really reaching out. I don't see anybody. You know what I mean? It's like your music only reaches a certain kind of crowd. So it's like you're not really gonna go far. You know, if you can't be international, if your music can't touch everybody, I feel like you'll never like make it at all. So that's dope that, you know, your music can touch people in that way to be an inspiration. Because even though I'm not an artist, you know, I'm an inspiration. So, you know, it is what it is. But this next question is kind of, how can I say? It's going to put you in the hot seat a little bit. Okay, I'm just warning you. All right? But I want you to be as honest as possible. Just give you an honest answer. I've heard all kind of answers with this question, so
yeah.
Shoot. Yeah. All right, so listening to what you listen to in the industry now, you know, who would you say, like, not fell off, but you feel like they could do more than what they've been doing and then what you've known them to do?
Oh, man, I feel like 50. And I've been up to this 50.com, I've been up 50 a couple of times. I feel like 50 got more good albums than I want to hear another album for 50.
Right.
I really want to hear that, I forgot what it is, Street King Immortal. Mm-hmm. It's been pushing back for a lot. I feel like 50 can still go.
Mm-hmm.
You know, music is incredible. And I've always been a fan of 50, so that's me mm-hmm. as a young kid growing up, listening to Power of the Dollar, right. Richard Dye, trying to massacre. Right. Mm-hmm. I want to hear more from 50. I feel like because he's made so much money, he don't really care too much about the music.
That's what a lot of artists though, you know what I mean? Right. I feel that way. I feel like a lot of artists get comfortable, you know what I mean? So they just feel like, all right, well, I've got money and it's still coming in, so I know I still got to produce music, so I'm going to produce the music.
Yeah.
You understand? But I still got loyal fans that's going to rock me regardless, no matter what I put out. And I get that feel from certain artists. You know, but I definitely agree with you. I would want to hear more from 50 Cent too, as opposed to him arguing with Mayweather and all these different people, get the strap and stuff. He's funny though.
Yeah, not that funny.
He's hilarious.
Word.
I cannot lie, that man, he's hilarious. His jokes be so on, his little memes, his captions. So mad.
Yo, and I'd be so entertained.
So entertained. But you gotta understand something, and I need people to understand this. Like, just like you're a regular person, these people are regular people. They just have money.
Yeah.
They're still human. You understand me? Like
that since day one.
Yeah, since day one. So it's like, how do you expect for money to change this man? Like, that's just the real in him. That's just something you can't take away from somebody at all. And you shouldn't try to take that away from them, because then they become fraud at that point. And I don't want to mess with nobody like that. You understand? So, like I tell everybody, keep the same energy.
Nice.
You understand me? Same energy you have when you meet me is the same energy I'm always going to keep.
That's
unless you change the energy.
Yeah,
you understand? So that's just it. So let's get into this. How many tracks you bought for this?
Two?
All right, so.
Yeah, I got the flash
drive. Yeah,
so let's get that. Let's get that up in there. And we're going to get into this first track. Let's get it rolling.
My man.
That's it. So this first track, what's the name?
Oh, Sex With Cat.
All right, this sound like a little strip banger, like they going to be in a club or a pole
night.
Oh, it's a love record? Oh, okay.
I'm on my black love shit.
Oh, all right. Well, black love, or you know I'm all for that. You understand? So where did this song come from?
I'm actually Lard and B producer. They work with a lot of people, amigos from down south. And we was in the studio one day and I wrote it and everything. So I wasn't saying the hook right. I was saying the hook right, but my voice wasn't like the singing type of shit. So Doe got in the booth. Oh, Doe got in the booth and killed it. You know what I mean? So, the record that we did.
Yep.
Oh, wow. That makes me.
Ah! See. Hold on.
Yeah. Wow.
Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
Hold on. So you good, we good.
We gotta start telling everybody, like,
word.
Everybody.
Yeah, like,
I mean, I think it's common sense to me, but I think we need to tell everybody, spread the word,
right,
that when you record your tracks, make sure you have a clean.
Both.
Me too.
You know what I mean?
The whole right.
Thing.
That's your fault.
Or word. Or it's gonna be played major radio, online radio, and no matter. Yeah. Just never know.
But we good today, so that was God. Look at God. You hear me? Yes, he is.
God's good.
Yes, God, he is all the time. So let's get into that track. I'll let you introduce it.
Oh yeah, that's Sex with Cash featuring DJ Dope Boy, man. Produced by Nard and B.
Hey, that's it. Let's get into it.
Let's do it.
WZYE. That's a different vibe that I haven't heard of yet at all. I can hear 50 in here a little bit. Like just a little bit. Like not the whole song, but it was certain parts. It was like, oh yeah, you can tell. You understand? Like, you know, just like my brother, he was a Lloyd Banks fan, and when he used to rap, I used to be like, boy, you sound like him. Like, you know, just certain things he would say, like certain metaphors or something like that, you know what I mean? Like, or a certain way he would put it, I'll be like, yep, that's a book out of Lloyd's. Definitely that. No, but it's dope. I like the sound. I like you. So who was singing? That was you singing?
DJ Dope.
Oh, that was DJ. Oh, he DJ.
Yeah, DJ.
Oh, and he just singing on tracks and stuff. You know,
my boy be singing in the clubs.
In the club? Like, he'll sing. Right in the middle of the party?
Yeah.
And he'll sing.
So he's a 2-for-1. He's a 2-for-1. I like stuff like that.
He actually worked with a lot of Queen Latifah and Faith Evans.
Mm-hmm.
He went to school with Faith Evans.
Oh, dope.
He's a DJ for Joe Budden.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's it. Well, I need to get more tuned in because, I mean, clearly.
Yeah, he's supposed to come up here, you know, you have a little situation, but, you know, we want to show love to him and shout him out.
Of course.
And we actually got a project coming soon, next year.
Yeah.
Me and Dope Boy.
Yeah. That's it. Making moves. It's about being booked and busy, keeping yourself busy, keeping yourself productive, and making sure it's actually an outcome after. You know what I mean? Just don't do it just to do it.
How did
y'all
connect though?
Cause
right.
You and Roselle and he.
You know how it is. I dancing through the club, coming through the club, just showing. Actually, he had a video shoot at the Gravelstone, and I showed up one day. And I met him before that, but then we just got cool, and then I would just go through the clubs and kick it, just on love shit. Not even just to get my records played, building a friendship, not even knowing. And then one day, when I was up here for Wala, he hit me and was like, "Yo, Ash, you a cool nigga. Let's do something together." I started listening to a lot of the music, so it's my boy. It's deeper than rap. So
we really
friends. Like, not me.
That is it.
I like that too.
Absolutely, because I mean, we also had a discussion up here a little while ago about people that blame their city or where they're from. You know what I mean? For them not being successful, and it's like you can't do that. You know what I mean? Like, you really can't. There's going to be people that are not going to support you. But that just goes to, or there's going to be people who supported you in the beginning, but then you get to a certain level and now they don't want to mess with you anymore because it's like they don't fit. You understand what I'm saying to you? Like, certain people just don't fit. It's not that you can't be friends with them. It's just like right now, where I am and where you are, it doesn't go together. You understand me? So it's like, you get what you got going together, I'm going to get what I got going together, and then maybe when we both get it together, maybe we could come together if it's on the same level. You understand me? But if you never get it together, I could block my blessings. You understand? Like, a lot of people block their blessings because they're like, oh, this is my boy. Like, I'm triple OG. You know what I mean? Like, loyalty. So they're like, yeah, you can still be loyal, but it's like, be loyal to yourself first.
You can be loyal from a distance.
Exactly, because at the end of the day, you could be broke and anything else, and your boy over here, he mentions anything. You don't know if he gonna do the same. You know what I mean? You don't know if he gonna leave. You don't know if he gonna be grimy and do something. You know what I mean? You never know how another person gonna play it. So it's like you always keep that distance between people, but you let them know it's always gonna be love.
Definitely.
You know? So I feel like that's where a lot of people get their relationships mixed up, and that's where a lot of beef comes from. With artists, you know what I mean, because they don't really respect each other. They don't really get an understanding of who each other are and respect boundaries, because it's always boundaries to everything.
And
you
I
do.
Think the expectations too, right. Like they feel like, because they might see a person on TV, mm-hmm. or they might see them in a car, they might feel like they have more money than
mm-hmm.
they have. A lot of the music is smoking.
Then what do we say? Social media is the devil.
Yeah,
they will make problems. They will have you thinking that somebody is just like living their best life.
Yes.
They sleeping in the car.
It was a good
trip.
Like I see them going on trips and everything, and I see them in the club, and I was like, yo, you doing your thing? I seen you on the Instagram and everything, and she was mm-hmm. like, oh, it's not real life, you know. I'm in the club.
Right.
You know, try to get this
out. Right.
So right. That's when I was like, wow, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I've seen it before, too, so.
But my thing is I don't feel like people should have to put their whole life story out there for people to respect what they do and them as a person or as an artist in general. You understand? It's like, if you respect my grind, respect it for what it is. Don't be mad because I'm not putting out what y'all want me to put out. Because mm-hmm. social media honestly glorifies bull.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to hold you. Like, everything on social media is almost just like so negative. It's like, yeah. but everybody's feeding into it. That's what they want. It's like they look for the next post that's gonna be like a fight. Somebody jumping somebody. Somebody getting the shooting on.
Oh yeah, I've seen that.
The shootings that they are recording and putting on social media is getting ridiculous.
He shot himself.
Yeah, like you dumb. Like you just dumb.
That was the stupidest.
You're
thing
dumb.
I've seen.
Like you're just dumb. Like all like, for what though?
They gonna kill me.
What is all of that for? You know what I'm saying? Like,
just to be seen.
Yeah, just to be seen, or just to, people just bother me. Like, it could all be so simple, it's all common sense. You understand? But, like I said, it clicks to certain people at a certain time.
Not definitely.
You know? So, you said, before we get to these sponsors real quick, tell them where they can find you, your Instagram, or your social medias.
CashBurner5000, Instagram, CashBurner5000, Twitter. www.cashburner5000.com. All the projects is on iTunes, Spotify, Tidal, Amazon Music, iHeartRadio Music, every digital platform you can think of, the music's there. So if you want to check out some good music, just check me out.
Hey, that's it. Well, we definitely going to come back because we definitely got that second track that we got to play for y'all. So definitely keep it tuned in. You already know you rocking out with the Rush Hour Party, baby. It's your girl, the clapback queen herself, Lele, with my brother.
DJ Midnight, be untouchable, baby.
Nonfiction Radio.
Weekend started.
Yep.
It's Friday. So, do remember, we got those Slay with Lay dance classes tonight.
Yeah.
You already know. 39 East 39th Street, Patterson, New Jersey. $10 cover. I will be doing a Chris Brown song.
Which one? The new one?
It's off of his album.
Oh.
You know, it was about 40-something tracks on there, so, you know, it's never ending. But the song is called Only For Me.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's dope. It's a dope song. So come out, you know, Slay with Lay, you know, have fun, dance, and all that. Yeah, that's it. But back to our guests that we have. So you brought someone with you.
Oh, yeah.
So introduce yourself.
I'm Body Bag Moolah, man, SSC.
Body Bag Moolah.
Yes.
Moolah. Where do these names come
my,
from?
My name come from, I used to work in a hospital.
Okay.
And I used to see a lot of body bags.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I know it was.
I
should have
$500,000 in my life.
We saw so much money.
I bet. That's why I said.
My name relates to everything I'm about.
Money truck. I just always, you want to know what's so crazy? I heard about Money Truck, the back of it opened up on a highway one time.
Yeah,
it wasn't over here.
Yeah,
I promise you, I wish I was on that highway, all right?
But you would have been locked up,
too. Who would have been locked up?
All that money got barcodes on it.
Oh, yeah, they
took that back to
But I mean, you can't, that's not my fault. I was in traffic. It interrupted my view,
you gotta clean
sir. You understand me? I had to get off my window because I was going to crash. You know? Then it was going to be even more deep.
I mean, I'd have been right with you, though.
What? For real? It's smacking into my window and you want me to just let it go? Come on. Come on. I'll do a month.
That's cool.
As long as I can keep this in the stash, you heard? Like, because when I come home, I'm good. You feel me? That's crazy. So crazy. So.
Yes. 50 Cent. Mm-hmm. Even go back to the 70s. I like the Shell Lights. I like Phonics. Mm-hmm. All type of music. I'm just a dope artist.
He said I'm just a dope artist. Period. That's how you're supposed to do it. You know what I mean? Like everything around. Cause not for nothing, his flow back then kind of sounds like stuff they're, some of the stuff they're doing now.
Yeah, we can't see.
You know what I mean? Like we can't get that music now. It's like so we gotta resort back to the. You know,
I think, man, he probably would have, like, his own label, you know.
Probably. Signing checks himself, you know. Another Diddy. For real. Now, Cash.
I'm more on the commercial side, Rihanna.
That's it. Somebody said Chris Brown in here one day and almost flipped the chick. That's it. That's smart. You understand me? Like, nobody wouldn't, like, Chris Brown is dope. Rihanna is dope.
Real.
You get what I'm saying? Like they actually sell records, and
that music is going to club.
What?
Like, yeah, that music is going.
Well, I don't care what Rihanna do. Rihanna did everything imaginable with her music. You understand me? And she's just lit go. She don't went techno on him a little bit. You know what I mean?
She could do anything.
EDM.
Absolutely. Yeah. Like she is really dope. That was an awesome answer.
Yes,
nobody ever said Rihanna. Mm-hmm. Nobody. Like, yeah, we had a few Beyonce. But that was girls, you know. I'm not really a Beyonce. I'm a Beyonce fan, but she's not like my number one.
She's not your number one?
No, Brandy is my number one. She's the first. Period. She's the
one. I like Monica.
I like Monica too, but Brandy is my number one for vocals.
She cuts your girl,
I don't care. It is what it is. You win some, you lose some.
I'm a best
okay?
Friend.
Yeah. That's it. But my girl is undeniably dope. Like, yeah, you making me drop my phone and stuff like that. You getting me all discombobulated over here.
Nah, don't do that.
All right, we're not gonna do that.
But Rihanna though.
Rihanna, that's a dope answer. Like I said, we never got the answer before. And you said Biggie.
What about Rihanna and Biggie on the track? That would be fire.
Rihanna and Biggie on the track. Ooh, that would have been evolutionary. Like on a whole nother. Yeah. Y'all created some vibes in this room right now. Because now my brain is going. And I'm thinking of what it would sound like.
What if?
Yeah, like what if they did do a track together? Like, y'all picking my brain in here a little bit.
Just a little bit.
But I'm loving it. Now, I'm going to let you guys go individually. Because we're about to wrap this up. We got to get back into the party. But I definitely appreciate you guys coming up here rocking out. We do have this next track coming up. So before you introduce your track, again, hit them with your info. You hit them with your info where they can find all your music, everything like that.
Cash Brother 5000, Instagram. All my music's on all the digital platforms. So check it out. Pain Cuts Deep out now. Support it. You know? Jersey.
That's it.
Okay, it's Body Bag Moving Man. That's
it. Man, produced by Nuno B.
Let's get it. Frenzy.
Nonfiction Radio.
Hey. I'm vibing over here, easy. That right there had a Tupac vibe a little bit.
Yeah.
The beat. Look, I'm telling you, I know music.
Nah,
you ain't got, okay? That music is my thing. Yeah. You understand me? I can pinpoint, but yeah, definitely that. Definitely heard the 50 on that again. Your flow. But the beat, definitely, I'm rocking with the beat. I love different. Yeah. That's me. Like, different, I love. Because it kind of opens the door for other people that have unique sounds to not be scared to let it be known. You know what I mean? Because I know a lot of people who venture off into different types of music, but the world is not really accepting to it. So for people to make a breakthrough for them, that's amazing. Really amazing.
Yeah, compare me to Grace. That's a good thing.
Huh?
Compare me to Grace.
Yeah. Like, no, I'm just telling you real. Like it really.
Yeah,
it really is. I'm not even going to, I wouldn't be me if I didn't keep it real. Okay? You heard? That's it. But, like I said, thank you, Cash, for coming through. We got Moolah.
Man, Body Bag Moolah, man.
Body Bag Moolah. Body Bag Moolah.
5,000.
Excuse me. But, Cash, 5,000. That's it?
Cash burner 5,000.
Cash burner 5,000.
Shout out to the Rush Hour Party, man. Everybody involved.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Layla.
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 Beautiful Layla.
Yeah. Trying to cover that up with the beautiful one. Thank you. But you know, get the name right, right? That's it. But thank you for rocking out with us. Definitely appreciate it. Definitely appreciate you for bringing the music up here. Rocking out. Definitely a dope vibe in the room. I was feeling it. Hope you guys were feeling it too. But we're going to get back into this music. Keep rocking out with us. We got, you know, a couple more minutes left. So I'm going to let my brother DJ.